welcome to Beer Goggles Reviews, and I'm quite excited because I've had two beers from this brewery, the Purity Brewery, and Brewery. God dear, Purity Brewery. Anyway, I've had two beers from them, and they've been awesome, absolutely fantastic. I had the Ubu, the little mad dog, and I've had the Mad Goose. That was fantastic. And now I'm going to have Pure Gold. Really looking forward to this one. This is Premium Golden Ale, even. Handcrafted and brewed using only premium ingredients. By dedicating our efforts to the highest standards, we create beers that are distinctive, characterful, that's a good word, and above all, a satisfying drink. This is Marisotta Carigold, Northern Brewer, Fuggles, Hereford Goldings and Styrian Goldings. Ho ho ho! Hereford Goldings, eh? I've never heard of Hereford Goldings. I've heard of East Kent and Styrian, but must be a new strain. Or strain yourself getting it up there. Right. Crack it open, let's go. There is the very, very lovely crown. Hey, up there you go on bottle cap Jenga mounting. All ready to fall down. Ooh! Pour it quick. I ain't had a chance to sniff the neck there. Beautiful golden colour. Looking absolutely superb. Here we go. Now, anyone that says these big kaplunky bubbles on the top kind of denote a bad beer, with all respect, are talking cobblers. But there you go. Because I've had tight little bubbles and it's been manky beer. And I've had big bubbles, been delicious beer. I've kind of, it doesn't really denote a lot. The way they rise up through the, the way they rise up through the glass, through the liquid, that denotes a different mouthfeel. If you look at those, they're kind of relaxed. They're not going, you know, like the, when you see on the Foster's advert, when they're like, you know, this, these are just like, oh, like a little ballet, a little conga line, you know. Anyway, chin chin, let's have a sniff. You're getting biscuity notes on the nose. You're getting kind of digestive biscuits on the nose. Something like honey on the nose, but like a toffee or something like that, but tiny, you know, wafer thin on the nose. There's not massive amounts on the nose, but that was the same with the Mad Goose, and when it hit me mouth, it was like, yeah! It was lovely. Right, so, chin chin, let's have a little go with this down hatch. Oh, that is so superb. You really can taste quality ingredients there. You really can. There's a beautiful, big, late finish that I believe will be coming off the Fuggles there. No, probably the Northern Brewer. Big, late, dry finish coming on there that I've kind of only ever got before off of the Beta Hop, you know. It's a big dry, kind of almost a Chardonnay sort of finish on it. That's really lovely. And it cries out for more. Let me just get the other notes in. Such a beautifully balanced symphony of flavours. All in chord. There's no discord going there. There's a beautiful, soft, almost buttery sort of kind of shortbread biscuit, just smooth in itself. You know, one of them that melts in your mouth and just smooths. You don't even have to chew it, just and it goes. Whoa. One of those that's in there. A slight mintiness, like a distant peppermint. You got lemon. Grape skins, all sorts of stuff, all sorts of really delicious stuff. That's a thing of beauty. That really is lovely. Well, and also what I like about this is it wouldn't be a culture shock to one of your lager boys, and that, you know, you could steer them towards this if you was kind of it. I mean, God bless them. We've all got mates that are lager boys and that, you know, and it's a little bit kind of hard on us sometimes that a lot of our mates might be lager boys, the Old Fosters and Carlin and all that, and you go out for a drink and you either got to go in one of these, like, McWidescreen pubs, or you got to try and find a cask pub that will serve McLagers and that, you know, and it's never the twain shall meet, so you end up drinking a Guinness in a muck pub. Which is kind of a, you know, you've got your mates there, but you, Guinness is nice, draft Guinness, but you kind of, when you want to try out all these other ales and things, and they ain't having it, you know. But sometimes you can sort of be round the house and bring a bottle of that around and a bottle of this and whatever else. Crack them open, share them out. And something like that, it's not going to be too much of a culture shock. They're not going to be like, oh, I don't like that. It's going to be like, oh, tell, that's lovely. That really is nice. And that really is. And that will turn a few heads. That really will turn a few heads. Oh, that's something else. Even a bit of tangerine in there as well. Listen, go out, buy it, buy it or else. That is superb, pure gold. And that is pure gold. Cheers, chin chin, bottoms up, bye.